mind-boggling, which is very insensitive, and we are calling on government today. We want to see the commodities cleared from the ports. Our next line of action is that we are going to collect signatures from across the country so that when we demonstrate, we will send these signatures to let the president, to let parliament know that Ghanaians find this situation utterly unacceptable.
In this country, because their voices matter, because they are on the ground, they know what is happening, and they are affected and infected by the disease, apart from the general population. If you look at malaria, Africa has the highest burden of malaria. If you look at TB, Africa has the highest burden of TB. If you look at HIV, Africa has the highest burden of all these diseases. Now, countries help us to own our own health. Why should we leave these resources? More importantly, the commodities at the port. There has been a lot of effort. I'm on their platform, and I've been seeing this communication for the past 1 year. Several assurances, and it's so disheartening to see that Ghana, our government, has not been able to clear this up till now. And it is really mind-boggling. Now, it is important that the government knows that the citizens need these services. We cannot just compromise the lives of people, especially the vulnerable population in this country, to die because of somebody's irresponsibility. And I think this has to continue. Global Fund, I'm actually not talking for Global Fund, I'm talking as a Ghanaian. Global Fund is really there to support all of us. But one important thing is that we must show political will. We all know that health is political will. If the government decides to support this, they can use half a minute to clear it. The question is, what is the problem? Civil society and communities want to know. Now, one important thing that I want to talk about is that a lot of countries are granting immunity to the Global Fund. The immunity means that when they bring you commodities, you must allow free clearance. What is the blockage? That is the question. Why is the highest office of this country, the presidency, promising us that, oh, it will be cleared, and then only to know that the things are still there? I think these are questions that we have to ask to protect the image of the sovereign country that we are all part of, and also to make sure that Global Fund resources are protected and secured. The CCM is supposed to oversee Global Fund resources and everything that comes to this country. And I'm happy that this is being organized with the CCM leading, with civil society and communities being part of it. I mean, we cannot do anything. We cannot strengthen health systems. We cannot strengthen community system without the voices of communities, without the voices of civil society. I want to add that Global Fund new strategy is putting people and communities at the center of the strategy. Look at the resources that they've given to us as a country. Should we leave the resources? And commodity is part of the resources. So should we leave it? So my worry as a person on the board, and a community member and a civil society member, is that we are not serious as a country if this continues. We need to stand up. And the voices might stand up. Chokwe! Hey! Chokwe! Hey! We cannot wait for life to be lost because of people's irresponsibility and people's personal interest. Thank you very much.
Okay. So because it's a coalition, it's important that we hear the voices.
Every day, a tree nipa 39 as a result of TB. 39. And 14 days in the crown, you calculate here about 546 Ghanaians in the best show among by then 14 days. You know, a bit my aminia, a bit my downfall, a bit my OBIB. And I didn't know on my yet nasty, near to me, in draw, I was here, it's me call, and my yafa, and my young toy, you know. Yenti mi enye de enko a nipa 39 ine ewu de bia e wo se itimi ehun a year no nipa 45,000 ah e wo se itimi ehun om so mo TB mbo wa ni bi yare ni bi ah e wo se de yeden yedimi om tu ndro so e mo mutimi fa e mo mo tom. As you speak now, for the past 15 years no 45,000 in draw. It's an say commodity CB. Of cartridges, I was a facility for diagnosis now. Ain't be any one of them. Last year, you had shortages of cartridges. Ain't your TB notification, no, echoes for 19,000 cases out of the 45,000. To see on cartridges, no, I can't. And to see if I say, yeah, yeah, near two TB assets by 2035, they are, or 2030 now. Now, we say, I'm buying a share because 546 they be within 14 days, you know. And you're needless, they won't hear. And you were a won't hear. I will say, yes, my Ghanaians, it's me a won't because of that. Madam,
thank you. The last one, yeah.
In May 2023, at the time the country was submitting the GC7 funding request. However, this letter has not been signed for the past 1 year and is now posed as a threat to the disbursement of funds to the country. In view of the above, we, the leadership of CSO networks, whose area of operations mainly focus on HIV/AIDS and malaria and TB, plan to stage a mass public demonstration to present a petition to the presidency and parliament for immediate action on these two critical issues. We wish to use this medium to invite all CSO activists and all well-meaning Ghanaians across the 16 regions of the country to join us. The proposed date is Wednesday, April 17, 2024, and the convergence point is Obrasport, Kwame Nkrumah Circuit Interchange, at 7 a.m. The proposed route is through Akwaje Interchange to Jubilee House and later to Parliament through Liberation Circle, that is Range Bypass. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the message that we have for you this morning.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more updates.